Hi, welcome to this video where I will explain the backyard estimate app for your Garmin watch. When running backyard ultras, it is actually smart not to run too fast. But if you run too slow, you're out of the game. So it's all about being able to run as slow as possible and still have some breaks in between the loops. To do that, you can plan the run well and so on, or you can use the backyard estimate app. And that's the one I have here now. While running, you will always see an estimate of how much time you are going to use on this loop. Of course, nothing is certain, but you see here it says 46 minutes, 47. Now I'm slowing down. That's why the estimate is growing. Also the green dot you see, that's a graphical representation of what time I'm going to use. When it passes 1 hour, it gets this large view and a white dot inside it to indicate that now I'm moving too slow. If I stop completely, then you see the estimate will grow even more, and then it tells me simply to move and to be able to get to finish this loop in 56 minutes. I have chosen 4 minutes break. Then I need a pace of 8:35 on each kilometer. Okay, I start moving again, and you see when I start moving, the pace will soon be replaced by a car is coming here. Now the pace is replaced by a new estimate.
Installing the app is done by using the Connect IQ app on your smartphone. Simply search for backyard and you will find the backyard estimate. There you may read description and so on, and then press the install button. If you like the app, you may leave a review as well. Thank you for that.
After installing the app in the Connect IQ app, you won't see anything on the watch. You need to add this app to one of your data fields. You could do that in an existing activity, for instance on running, but I recommend adding a new activity type. If you press one step up here, then you have the ability to add a new activity. Here I recommend using copy activity and copy one of your existing activity types. The running activity is perhaps the most convenient one. Then you need to give it a name, running backyard for instance. After that, it's important not to press back, but go to the done. Set as favorite, of course. You should also place it among your favorites, for instance, along with your existing running activity or the one you copied. You choose. Inside your new activity, you need to add your data field. Press and hold this up button. Then you can go to your running backyard settings. Enter data screens. Then you will see the first screen of this copy of your running activity type. You need to go all the way to the bottom where you have the add screen ability. Press one step up and you go directly down there. Add a new screen, custom data. Layout should be one data field like this. Choose field one. Here you see I have 0 of 2 available Connect IQ fields added. I want to choose one of my IQ fields, and you see here I find the backyard estimate. The location of this screen could be placed by using up and down arrows. I recommend putting it at the top. Press one step down and it's automatically added to the top here. Then you are finished, but you need to press on the back button, then go back again and another back. And you're ready to use your running backyard. And you see here it is. I go back. There is at least one setting you should be aware of. I go back to the settings for this running backyard. Press and hold here and go into running backyard settings. Here you see I have this auto lap. Make sure this one is manual. You may also want to set the background and so on. You have this background color. I prefer black, but that's up to you. And there are other settings as well you may want to set. So that's convenient.
Before going back outside, let's have a look at the settings. You may use the Connect IQ app to set them. Simply press the settings. You can set 4 settings regarding beeps and vibrations. They are default on. The 5th setting is an ability to switch the estimate and the flat estimate. The flat estimate does not take into account the previous loop. You may also choose to have an unfilled green circle representing the flat estimate unless you have switched them. You can also set the size of the dots, recommend 3 or 4. The ruler is not really necessary. It's only there to simplify and ease the way of viewing the dots. You may enlarge the size of the digits a little bit by using big digits mode, and then you remove the labels. The custom field is used to add information of your own choice to the data screen. The desired number of minutes is used to suggest the pace in case you stop, and it's used to give a white dot inside the green dot. You can create your own backyard loop by altering the number of minutes between each loop start and the loop distance in kilometers. After pressing the save button, you will get a confirmation message saying that the new settings are available in your watch, but they are not available until the next loop or if you press the lap button.
In a backyard race, it's actually a decision you make how much time you want to use on each loop. So then, why do you need a backyard estimate? And why do you need an app to estimate your time? Well, that's simply because when you're running, you know you never want to break the hour. In that case, you're out. So while running, now I've been running 3.2, 3.3 kilometers. And you see my estimate is 54 minutes. If I now slow down, let's look at the numbers. I slow down to slow walking pace and wait for a while. And you see then it breaks the hour. So I cannot be walking as slow as this for all the remains of this loop. But if I increase my pace a little bit, I try walking a bit faster. So I'm still walking, but let's look at the estimate. You see the green dot? It goes closer to the hour. And you see, I may get just below the hour. You see here, with this pace, even if I'm only on 51% of this loop, still I can use this pace now on all the remains of the loop without being afraid of breaking the hour. Of course, I should have some more to go on than that, but that's the benefit of this app. I can test simply by walking or running in a pace I think I may want to use for the remains of this loop, and then I can take it easy. So now I'm walking a bit faster than I would do normally, but you see the estimate is 58 minutes. That makes it very easy. You see the red dot? That's the minutes, same as the number I have at the right up there, 25:34. That's how far I am into the hour in minutes. The arc I have, that's a presentation of the distance. If this red dot catches me back, I have to speed up a bit. And I need to finish this loop before the red dot. So the outer arc must be finished before the red dot finishes. And the green dot tells me where the red dot will be when I'm finished. So now I need to speed up again. And I will try again. I won't walk like this. You saw now the estimate was a bit more than an hour. So I will run a little bit more and then start taking it easy. Yeah, now I've been running 4 kilometers. And it's again time to look at what happens now if I slow down. The estimate is 43 minutes, so I'm running too fast. If this had been a race, that would be stupid. But I've been running 4.6 kilometers. And you see now when slowing down, I'm walking pretty slowly. And you see the estimate, it approaches 1 hour, was a little bit above, but this is, it's no problem. Here I'm coming to a hill, so I need to go up here, but still, you see, I keep below the hour. So now, this is a pace I could keep, with no trouble. As long as the GPS is correct and accurate and so on. So you shouldn't push it too far. But this is the core of this app. Looking at that number makes you relax. So you could say, I'm starting my break already now. It's 27 minutes to the next start. And I can relax all those 27 minutes. Even though I have to walk these uphills. I don't walk fast enough. I speed up a little bit to get below the hour. I don't want the green dot to be large. And you see, then it goes down immediately. Very useful. I also see on the left hand side that this is loop number one. On the next loop, I will see 2 arcs, like the yellow one. The outer arc is my current distance. I will also get a green one on the next one, showing my previous loop. How am I now compared to the same relative time on the previous loop? So now I will relax to the goal and soon start loop 2. I'm approaching the end of the loop and I'm slowing down. You see, I'm on 6.5 kilometers. And as you see, by slowing down, there's not much change of the estimate because I saw less way to go. So you should also know if slowing much down just before you reach the end of the loop, the app may consider it as the end of the loop because of a possible inaccuracy on the GPS. Very slow pace close to the end may close the loop. That's no problem. So far it estimates 52.5 minutes. I speed up a little bit just a few seconds in difference. And now you see, I'm at the end, so I stop here. And here I'm on 6.69. But when stopping, then it considers that as the end and it gives me the last loop time I have. The reason for showing this in two places is that the black and gray text, that's the only text shown if you show this in a smaller data view. So now when I'm using the entire screen, I have more information. So after a while, the black letters with 5206 will disappear. It will be replaced by a countdown. And the other information remains above. I've finished one loop and I have almost 7 minutes to go before the next one. So I hope you like this app. I will show you now soon when I start on the second loop and the difference between the estimate and the flat estimate. The watch counts down, and when it's ready, you're ready to run. And let's get down some stairs here. Now, at the start of this loop, you see, even when I'm running, my estimate is more than an hour for this pace. The flat estimate says 44 minutes, but the estimate is much more because I've been walking on my previous loop. I've been walking at the end of the loop, that's why I get such a high estimate. So if I will keep the same differences in pace on this loop as I had, I will have to speed up a little bit more now. Because of that. And you see, by running a bit more, sorry for the shaking, then you see my, oh, I need much more space here. Now you see my estimate goes below an hour. And that's how it continues. But again now, such early in the loop, you see, even by slowing down a little bit, the estimate increases a lot because I have so much more to run on, so much more left of this loop. So that's how it is.